a number in exponential form and what are the different terms are there in the exponential form and how to write a number in the exponential form using the factorization method and next how we can expand a number using the exponents. So all this we have discussed yesterday's class. Why we are using the exponents? To read and write very large numbers in easiest manner, we are using the exponential forms. Okay, that is the basic, that only the use of exponential numbers, that's all. And now, if I have like this, now it is in exponential form, yes or no? What is this meaning? So if when I am giving the exponential form, I want to write it the product form. That is 7 is multiplied 8 times. 7 into 7 into 7 like that 8 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 times. Now here what we will call for 7 and what we will call for 8. 7 is base or radix, other name. Okay. And 8 is power or exponent or index. So that's why it is named as exponential form, otherwise index notation also, because we are using here exponents are indexes. Okay, indices. Now observe here how to read this number. 7 is raised to the power of 8. So first one is base and last one is power, we must indicate. Okay, so this is the way of expressing a number in the exponential form and how to identify their terms 7 and 8, what we are calling them and how it is reading. Okay, so this is about all these topics we have finished yesterday's class. Today we will learn what are the laws of exponents, different laws, and with the examples we will see. Before that we have the relations, yes or no? Mensuration relations. 1 kilometer is equal to how much? 1000 meters. Just measurements I am giving. And 1 hectometer is equal to how much? 100 meters. 1 decameter is equal to 10 meters. 1 decimeter is equal to 1 by 10 meters. 1 centimeter is equal to 1 by 100 meters. 1 millimeter is equal to 1 by 1000 meters. Have you learned about these measurements in before classes? Yes, from 6th class onwards you are getting measurements, all these. So measurements are nothing but we have 3 types of measurements, means 3 types of quantity. That is length, mass, capacity. For the length we are using the basic unit meters. Okay, kilo refers to same value, 1000 only. If it is length, we have to take meter as the basic unit. For mass is nothing but weight. Wherever we are getting weight related problem. For suppose 1 kilogram, 1 kg of sugar. In that case, 1 kg means 1 kilo value 1000, 1000 grams. That quantity we are referring in the measuring in terms of grams, because that is related to mass. And coming to third quantity, capacity. Capacity is nothing but whatever liquid forms we are getting. For suppose oil, we will measure in liters. So 3 types of different units we have: length, mass, capacity. Basic units of length is meters, mass is grams, capacity is liters. Okay, and these values will not change. For kilo means 1000 only, hecto is 100, deca 10, deci 1 by 10, centi is 1 by 100, milli is 1 by 1000. If that is related to length problem, then we have to take 1 kilometer like that. Whereas if I want to write the same measurements for mass. Means basic unit is gram. So 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 grams. There is no change for this kilo. That numerical value of kilo is 1000 and hecto is 100. If I am using mass, then 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 grams. 1 hectogram is equal to 100 grams. 1 decagram is equal to 10 grams. Like that will. Why I am telling this now? And for capacity, instead of meters or grams, we have to use liters. That's it. Why I am using this? Till here, we can write in exponential form. See, 10 is multiplied 3 times, so 10 cube meters. Now here, 10 square meters. And it is 10 power 1 meter. What about 1 by 10? That is the reason I am explaining. 1 by 10, that is nothing but here 10. When division, in the denominator, if you are having the number, let it be into the numerator by taking the inverse. 1 by 10 is the inverse of 10. Yes or no? So 10, multiplicative inverse of 10 is 1 by 10. 10 inverse is its multiplicative inverse of 10. 1 by 10 is nothing but 10 to the power of minus 1 meter. And 1 by 100, first of all, 100 write in the exponential form. That is 1 by 100 we can write as a 10 square in the exponential form. Now, bring this term to the numerator. What it will become? 10 to the power of minus 2. That's it. Multiplicative inverse of 10 square is a 10 power minus 2. Negative powers. Numbers with negative exponents we are seeing now. And next, 10 cube. 1 by 10 cube actually it is. So by bringing up there, it will become 10 power minus 3 meters. That is, a power minus n is equal to 1 by a power n. This is my first law. Okay, inverse of any number is referred as a to the power of minus n in the exponential form. Okay, that's all. So here n is the power of that number. Means whatever number they are giving for, suppose 1 by 8 I wrote. So try to write 8 in the exponential form first. So 8 is nothing but to use prime factorization method. 2 4s are, 2 2s are, 2 1s are. That means 1 by 2 cube it is. Okay. So 1 by 2 cube. It is inverse now. So by simplifying this, we will get 2 to the power of minus 3. That's all. So this is the general law which we are using in the exponents. That is, a to the power of minus n is equal to 1 by a power n. Okay? So first of all, I am giving the laws of exponents. So what are the different laws of exponents we are going to discuss now? And just as I told you, whenever we are getting the exponents in the denominator, then we are using the negative exponents for simplifying. Okay, for suppose. So my first law, as I told you, negative exponent whenever is there, we will make it as a positive by taking it in the denominator. If I have a power n in the numerator, then 1 by a to the power of minus n it will become. If we are minus, it will become plus. If plus, it will become minus. That's all. Now, secondly, so for example, this question. 10 to the power of minus 10. What I should write? 1 by 10 to the power of 10. That's it. Okay? And secondly, first of all, take the laws of exponents. After that, you will see the questions on that. So we have different laws, all those I am listing now. These laws only, by using these laws of exponents only, we can solve the questions which are in exponential form. Now a power minus n is equal to 1 by a power n, and a power m into a power n. So just observe here, two numbers a power m and a power n, observe their bases, a only, means in these two numbers bases are equal. So when two numbers are having bases are equal and they have been multiplied, then their exponents will be added, that is a to the power of m plus n with the same base. For suppose I have 5 cube into 5 to the power of 7, like this. Here base is same and I am using the operation into. In that case I must add the exponents, that is 5 is my base, equal base, exponents are 3 and 7, so between them I must use addition operation, that will be equal to 5 to the power of 3 plus 7 is 10. So this is the simplified form of this product, understand? So whenever two exponents are having same base and they have been multiplied, then their exponents must be added, that is the second law. And when bases are equal, same bases, and between them division operation we have. Instead of multiplication, if we are going for division, then that will be a to the power of m minus n. Okay, a to the power of m minus n, that formula we must use. Okay, here also some numbers are there, a power m minus n when m is greater than n. If n is greater than m, in that case 1 by a to the power of n minus m we will get. So that one we will discuss later on, while we are doing the problems I'll explain. But basical formula is this one: when two numbers are having same base and exponents are different and they have been multiplied, in that case we need to add the exponents. A power m into a power n is equal to a power m plus n. See all these laws not only from left to right, right side to left side also we must by heart, we must learn, then only we can solve the problem. Now, and another law is a power m divided by a power n is equal to a power m minus n. If I am having the question in this form, for suppose 5 to the power of 6 minus 3. In this case, I want to reduce, that is 5 to the power of 6 by 5 to the power of 3. Because of minus, I must use by, that's all. So, remember, not only from left to right, right side to left side also, we must learn the formula. So first formula is a power minus n is equal to 1 by a power n. Otherwise 1 by a power n is equal to a power minus n. Next, a power m into a power n is equal to a to the power of m plus n. And a to the power of m divided by a to the power of n is equal to a to the power of m minus n. Whenever division we are getting, then that will be negative. Subtraction we must do. And next, fourth one. Different bases are there, but exponents are same and they have been multiplied. Multiplication operation, different bases, but exponents are equal. In this case, those two will be multiplied and they are combined together. That is, a power m into b power m is equal to a into b whole power m. That is, ab whole power m. And next, same thing, division operation. A power m divided by b power m is equal to a by b whole power m. That's all. Next, sixth property. When one number is having is in exponential form, again we have the exponent further. That is a power m whole power n, exponent to exponent. In that case, we have the simplification. These two will be multiplied. Exponents will be multiplied. A to the power of m into n. And next we have any power 0 is equal to 1. And again, any number power 1 is equal to that number itself. So for suppose 10, I am telling. 10 is nothing but 10 power 1 itself. So now listen once more time. These are the different laws of exponents. Using these laws, we are going to do this problem. We are going to solve the problem. So total eight laws we have. Observe all these laws, and you need to learn these laws also. Then only we can simplify any question. So now, a power minus n is equal to 1 by a power n. A power 0 is equal to 1. A power 1 is equal to a. A power m into a power n. Same basis. So a power m plus n. A power m divided by a power n. Same basis. In that case, a power m minus n. A power m and b power m. Between them into is there. A power m into b power m. That is a b whole power m. A power m divided by b power m. A by b whole power m. A power m whole power n is equal to a to the power of m into n. Exponent to exponent. In that case, exponents will be multiplied. Okay. So that is about laws of exponents. Now we will see some of the examples on laws of exponents. Okay. My first some of the questions I am giving. Observe. Find the following. First one is 3 power minus 5. Secondly, 4 power minus 3. Third one, 7 power minus 4. 7 power minus 3. X power minus n. 1 by 4 cube. 1 by 10 cube. So like this I have the questions. Now I want to simplify the first one. So here no need to write their values. Just we need to use the formulas, and as much as possible in exponential form only we must represent the given numbers. Now 3 power minus 5 is in which form? Now observe. Which law is useful here? That is a to the power of minus n only, no? So a power minus n, what is its simplification? 1 by a to the power of n. Is it right? So instead of a, we have a 3. Okay, instead of a, 3 is there. In place of n, 5 we have. So a to the power of minus n, 3 to the power of minus 5. That is 1 by 3 to the power of 5 plus 5. That's all. So 3 to the power of 5, if you want to write the value, write down. Otherwise, no need. So I am writing 243 is the 3 power 5 value. If you have any doubt, observe. 3 multiplied 5 times. Okay. 3 threes are 9. 9 nines are 81 into 3. 3 ones are 3. 3 eights are 24. 243. But no need to do this step. Actually, till here enough. Okay. So now coming to the second question. Single step answer. Second question. 4 power minus 3. Again it is in which law? Like this only, no? So simplify like that only. That is 1 by 4 cube. 4 cube is nothing but a 64. 4 4 is a 16. 16 4 is a 64. That is 1 by 64. It is 1 by 243. And coming to the third question. 7 power minus 4, which is equal to 1 by 7 to the power of 4. Next. Fourth question. 7 power minus 3, that is nothing but 1 by 7 cube. And fifth question, x power minus n. So instead of a, x is there, n is same. So 1 by a to the power of n. A to the power of n is nothing but x to the power of n here. And next problem, 1 by 4 cube. Just observe till now we got a power minus n form. Question is in the form of a power minus n. Then we have simplified 1 by a power n. Now question only 1 by a to the power of n form. Then reversely we must use, that is a to the power of minus n. That's all. That is 4 to the power of minus 3. Seventh question. 1 by 10 cube. So that is 10 to the power of minus 3. Understood? So like that we must use. That's why I am telling, not only left to right, right to left also we must know the formula. So what is the first law? A power minus n is equal to 1 by a power n. That is 1 by a power n is equal to a power minus n. Now coming to the next question. See, you have a speed formula. Speed is equal to distance by time. Yes? Speed is equal to distance by time. Formula we have, no? In science, physics, you got this question, is it? You got this formula. Speed, S is equal to D by T. And here, what are the units for speed I want to find now? Units of speed. Distance is, what are the basic units of distance? Distance means length only, no? So meters. And what are the basic units of time? Seconds. Basic units we must refer while we are calculating. General units of the any quantity, compulsory you have to take basic units. So basic units of distance is meter and time is second. Meter by second. By is nothing but so units of speed is equal to meter second inverse. S power 1. We want to write in the numerator, that is S into minus 1. S to the power of minus 1. S inverse we have to take. So, what is the units of speed? Meter per second. Meter per second. Per is nothing but by. Meter per second. Otherwise, meter into second inverse. That's all. Now, coming to the next problem. If I have given one number, I want to write in the exponential form. So, 3,456 and secondly 326.57, like this I have two numbers. I want to express these numbers in the exponential form using exponents. Yesterday also we have covered this question. Once again I am explaining. Observe here. 3 is in thousands place, so 3000 plus 4 is in hundreds place, so 400. Expanded form using exponents. Exponents. All these are comes under exponents only. Why I am telling you now? Next you will understand. 5 into 10, 50 plus 6, 1's are 6. That's all. 3,000, 400, 5, 10's, 6, 1's in this number. Now, write in the exponential form. 3 into 10 cube plus 4 into 10 square plus 5 into 10 power 1. Any number of power 1 is that number itself. 10 power 1 is 10 only. Plus 6 into any power 0 is 1. Just now we have finished those last. Any power 1 is that number itself. Any power 0 is 1. Any number power 0 is 1. Now, so this is the exponential form using the exponents. Understand? Now one more question I am giving. 326.57. I want to write exponential expanded form of this decimal number first. So that is 3 is in hundreds place, so 300. 2 is in tens place, so 20. 6 is in ones place, so 6. Before the point it is whole number part, ones, tens, hundreds, like that we must say. After the point, decimal place, decimal point. So 5 is in tens place, that is 5 by 10. Yes? Plus 7 is in hundreds place, that is 7 by 100. Now, write its exponential form. 3 into 10 square plus 2 into 10 plus 6 into 10 power 1. 6 into 10 power 0 plus 5 into 10 is in the denominator. I want to bring into the numerator. 10 power minus 1. 1 by a power n is equal to a to the power of minus n. So these three formulas we have used for these three terms now. Into 7 by 100, that is 7 into 100 by bringing outside 10 power minus 2. So, just observe some of the questions. If that is a whole number or in the whole number, then in that case, directly positive exponents we are getting. In case of decimal numbers, we are getting the negative exponents also. So, wherever negative exponents we are getting, in that case, we must use the law a power minus n is equal to 1 by a power n. Okay. So now some of the questions I will explain on this topic only now. Expanded form using exponents. Now first question is 543.67 and secondly 7054.243 and thirdly 6523.45. Like this, I have three questions I want to expand by using the exponents. So as I told you, whenever decimal numbers we are getting, we will get the negative exponents. So here, before the point, as usual, we must elaborate ones, tens, hundreds. That is, 5 is in hundreds place, so 500, plus 4 is in tens place, so 40, 3 is in ones place, so 3, plus 6 is in tens place, so 6 by 10, 7 by 100. That is, in exponential form, 5 into 10 squared. Two zeros, no, 10 squared. 4 into only 1 zero is there, that is 10 to the power of 1. Any number power is, power 1 is that number only. And 3 into 10 power 0. Any power 0 is 1. 3 ones are 3. Okay? Plus 6 into 10 power 1, this one. So by bringing up the 10 to the power of minus 1 into 100, we can write as 10 squared. In the numerator, it will become 7 into 10 to the power of minus 2. So this is the expansion by using the exponents. Same second one also like that only do. 7 is in 1s, 10s, 100s, 1000s. So 7000 plus 0. For 0, no need to write the place value because place value, face value, always 0 for 0. Now 5. 5 is in 10th places, so 50. Next 4 plus 2 is in 10th place, 2 by 10. 4 is in 100th place, 4 by 100. 3 is in 1000th place, 3 by 1000. So which will be equal to 7 into 1000 is nothing but 10 cube. Plus 5 into, so square, 100th term not there here. 5 into 10 power 1. Plus 4 into 10 power 0. Plus 2 by 10, 2 into 10 power minus 1. Plus 4 by 100, 100 is nothing but 10 square, so 4 into 10 power minus 2. Plus 3 into 10 power minus 3, because 3 zeros I have. Understood? That's all. So try to write for this third number yourself. Now consider another class of exponents, depending on that different problem. So this is, these are all our examples for a power minus n, a power 0 and a power 1. Okay, now one more example I am giving for the questions. Simplify the expressions, simplify and express the following as single exponent. Simplify and express the following as a single exponent. First one is 2 power minus 3 into 2 power minus 2. Secondly, 7 power minus 2 into 7 to the power of 5. And thirdly, 3 power 4 into 3 power minus 5. Fourth question, 7 power 5 into 7 power minus 4 into 7 power minus 6. And next fifth question, m power 5 into m power minus 10. And last question. Sorry, sixth question. Minus 5 to the power of minus 3 into minus 5 to the power of minus 4. And one more question I am giving. Seventh problem. 2 power 3 into 2 power 5. And eighth problem. Minus 3 to the power of 5 into minus 3 to the power of 7. Okay, these are the questions. Now observe the first problem. 2 power minus 3 into 2 power minus 2 I have. Here observe that these two are having the same base. That is the first thing. So when same base is there and multiplication operation, exponents are different. M into n. A to the power of m into a to the power of n form left side. Yes or no? What is its simplification? I told you whenever two are having same exponent and they are multiplied, then their exponents will be added. A to the power of m plus n. Here at left side we are having the form a power m into a power n. So what is its simplification? A to the power of m plus n. That's all. So 2 to the power of minus 3 and minus 2. Both are like integers. Add 3 plus 2 is 5. Both are having minus sign, so minus 5. But so if you want to leave here only, but for this one also we have the simplification. Is it right? What is that? A power minus n is equal to 1 by a to the power of n. So 1 by 2 to the power of 5. So once again I am telling, first identify the question. And which formula is suitable there? Two numbers are having same base, exponents are different, they have been multiplied. So its simplification is a to the power of m plus n. A power m into a power n is equal to a to the power of m plus n. Here I got in the formula a power m into a power n. Left side I have. So what is its right side? A to the power of m plus n. That's what I want to finish. Understood. Next, coming to the second question. Seven power minus 2 into 7 to the power of 5. Again, base is same into operation. So same question. So what is the base here? 7. M plus n. Minus 2 plus 5. 1 is minus, 1 is plus. Subtraction. So 5 minus 2 is 3 and 5 is having plus 10, so 7 cube. That's it. Here, positive powers only we got, so enough. Answer is finished there only. And third question. 3 power 4 into 3 power minus 5. Same as a power m into a power n. A to the power of m plus n. 4 plus half minus 5. 1 is plus, 1 is minus. Subtraction. So 5 minus 1 is 4 is 1. 5 is having minus 10, so minus 1. That is 3 to the power of minus 1. 3 to the power of minus 1 in the sense it is in the form of a to the power of minus n. So that is 1 by a to the power of n. So that is 1 by 3 to the power of 1. Any power 1 is equal to that number itself. Yes or no? So 1 by 3 power 1 is 3 only. So observe this question here. Firstly, we have used a power m into a power n formula, and after that by simplifying that negative power we got. For that also, for simplification we have one of the formula. That is 1 by 3 to the power of a power n, that is 3 to the power of 1. Any power 1 is equal to that number itself. So 1 by 3 power 1 is 3 itself. 1 by 3 is the simplification of this question. Now coming to the fourth problem. 7 power 5 into 7 power minus 4 into 7 power minus 6. See, even here 3 exponents are there. Observe, every term is multiplied and in every number we have the same base. So same formula, that is instead of 2 numbers, we need to take 3 exponents. That is 5 plus half minus 4 plus half minus 6. Here we have used the formula a power m into a power n is equal to a to the power of m plus n. That's all. Simplify this. 7 to the power of. These two are negative values, so they will be added. 6 plus 4 is equal to 10, and it is plus 5. So minus 10 plus of plus 5. Then 1 is minus, 1 is plus, subtraction. So 7 to the power of 10 minus 5 is 5, and 10 is having minus 10, so minus 5. Okay, that's all. Now it is in the form of a power minus n. So what is its simplification? 1 by a to the power of n. So that is 1 by 7 to the power of 5. That's all. Next, fifth problem. M power 5 into m power minus 10 will be equal to, both are having same base. So m to the power of 5 plus of minus 10. Since a power m into a power n is equal to a to the power of m plus n. Okay, that's all. So which will be equal to, 1 is plus, 1 is minus, subtraction. So m to the power of 5 minus 10, that is minus 5 itself. Again we got the negative power. So what is its simplification? 1 to the power of m power 5. That we got from a to the power of minus n is equal to 1 by a to the power of n. Okay. Next, sixth problem. Minus 5 to the power of minus 3 into minus 5 raised to the power of minus 4. In this case, again base is minus 5. Both the bases are same. So write the base first. Into, so this should be added. That is minus 3 plus of minus 4, which is equal to minus 5 to the power of 3 plus 4 is 7. That is minus 7. So negative exponent. Base I am not telling, negative exponent. So that is 1 by minus 5 to the power of plus 7. And remember, whenever negative number, if even number of times is multiplied, then positive will be the answer. But when odd number of times it is occurring, in that case minus as the result will get. So suppose I have minus 5 into minus 5, that means minus 5 multiplied twice, so even power, then I will get positive answers. Just observe, minus into minus plus, 5 5 is a 25, yes or no? If I have 3 times, in that case, minus 5 cube, cube is an odd number. In this case, minus into minus plus, plus into minus minus, 5 cube, 5 5 is a 25, 25 5 is a 125. Like this, my result I will get negative when power is odd. I'll get the when I'm getting even power, then this negative sign will be removed. That's all. So now observe this question. Minus 5 to the power of 7 I have. Base, when I'm talking about base, in case of exponents, just we have to bring down. That's it. So this is the new problem which is having negative base. And power is odd. In that case, result is 1 minus 1 by 5 to the power of 7. That's it. Because of 7, we are getting this minus 10. Understand? Now coming to the next question, seventh problem. 2 cube into 2 power 5. Both are having same base and powers also positive numbers. 2 to the power of 3 plus 5, which is nothing but 2 to the power of 8. That's all. And eighth problem. Minus 3 to the power of 5 into minus 3 to the power of 7. So both are having same base, minus 3. So a power m into a power n form, a to the power of m plus n, that is 5 plus 7, which is equal to minus 3 to the power of 5 plus 7 is equal to 12. Now observe, exponent is 12. There is no simplification for this. Now coming to the base is a negative value and it is multiplied 12 times. So even number, no. Our answer will be even number. So that is 3 to the power of 12, that's all. Okay, so remember these conditions. There only you take down. If base is a negative value and power is even number, in that case you will get the positive powers. to the power of n minus a to the power of n is equal to a power n if n is even. Okay, remember this. Minus a when base is a negative number and its exponent is odd number. Minus a to the power of n will be the result. That is if n is odd. Understand? For example, minus 3 square. So then 3 square is my answer because 2 is even number. And minus 3 to the power of 5. Then minus 3 to the power of 5 will be my answer because n is odd. That's all. Understand? Now coming to the next problem. Next law. Examples. Example 1. Find the value of 5 power minus 2 and secondly 1 by 2 to the power of minus 5 and third question minus 5 square. So just now whatever we finished those topics, depending on that only these examples are given. Now we will try to solve those problems. Observe that first question 5 to the power of minus 2. So it is in which form? Which formula is suitable? Just identify. Negative exponent, no? So that is a to the power of minus n form. Left side. What is its RHS? 1 by a to the power of n. So by observing the question, first of all identify it is in the which form. That's all. Now, so 1 by 5 square. Because it is very simple number, we can write its expanded form also. That is 5 square is nothing but 25. 5 is a 25. That's it. And second problem. One by 2 to the power of minus 5. So it is in which form now? 1 by a power n form. So that is a to the power of minus n. Yes or no? That means 2 to the power of minus n value is minus 5 here. A power minus n. N value is negative. In that case, we will get positive. So which is equal to 2 to the power of minus into minus plus 2 power 5. 2 power 5 value is 2 into 2 into 2. 2 multiplied 5 times. 2 2's are 4. 2 2's are 4. 4 4's are 16. 16 2's are 32. Understand? That's all. Now coming to the next third question. Minus 5 square. So here, what we have? Minus a to the power of n. Okay, is equal to a power n when n is even. So here, n value is even only, you know. So 2 is even number, so it will be equal to 5 square. So here we have used this one, minus a to the power of n is equal to a power n when n is even. So n is the even number here, 2 is even number. That's why minus 5 whole square is equal to 5 square. That is nothing but 5, 5 is a 25. That's all. Simplify the following. Second example. All these questions are negative exponent questions only. Just as observe this problem. And my second problem is simplify the following. Example 2. Simplify the following. So for this what I will get? And my first question is, -5 to the power of 4 into -5 to the power of -6. Second question is, 4 power 7 by 4 power 4. And third question is, 3 power 5 by 3 cube. Whole to the power of 5 into 3 power minus 6. Okay, these are the three questions given. Now, here it is very easy. Till now, this step we didn't do, just observe. This one we have done just now. Observe the first problem. It is in which formula? It is in which form? Identify. So, observe the given question. First, identify their basis, given number. So, here first number is having -5 as the base, second number also having the -5 as base. Means equal base and multiplied. So we must add the exponent. That is -5 to the power of 4 plus of -6. Yes or no? So it is by the formula a power m into a power n is equal to a to the power of m plus n. Why? Because at left side we got that a power m into a power n. A is minus 5 here. That is a to the power of m plus n. Now observe, simplify, that's it. Minus 5 to the power of plus 4 minus 6. 1 is plus, 1 is minus, subtraction. 6 minus 4 is 2 and 6 is having minus n, so minus 2. Now just observe negative exponent. That is, it is in the form of a power minus n. First exponent observe, after that this base negative. So first don't consider base as a negative value. Just consider the exponent negative. So a power minus n is equal to 1 by a to the power of n. Now simplify that. 1 by minus 5 whole square. And as we have a power minus a to the power of n is equal to a power n. If n is even, so here n is even. That's why 1 by 5 square will get a power n, a value 5. This minus also will get cancelled because of 2 is even number. So 5 square is nothing but 25. So 1 by 5 square is nothing but 1 by 25. That's all. So just identify the question first of all. In single step you may get the answer. Otherwise by do several steps also we need to finish the question. So first of all, it is in the form of a power m into a power n. So we have simplified. After the simplification also we didn't get its simplified form. Again we can able to simplify by using that formula. So after that also it is not finished. Still some more formula we have used and simplified. Okay. Now coming to the second problem. What are the given exponents and how are they given? Just identify that. So that is the basic thing. Now 4 power 7 by 4 power 4 given. That observe these two exponents, 4 power 7 and 4 power 4, having same base 4, same base 4. So first of all, we need to check for bases, after that exponents, okay? When bases are equivalent, division operation is there. A power m divided by a power n. What is its simplification? Subtraction we have to do for the exponents. Yes or no? That's it. That is 4 to the power of 7, m is in the numerator and n value is in the denominator. M a power m by a power n. So 7 minus 4, that is 4 power 3. 4 cube is nothing but 4, 4 is 16, 16, 4 is 64. And coming to the third problem, okay, third problem. So I hope you understood. When into is there, same basis and into is there, add the exponent. When same basis side division operation is there, go for subtraction, subtracting the exponent. Now coming to the third question here, several formulas are there in this problem. 3 power 5 by 3 cube whole power 5 into 3 power minus 6. First of all, simplify whatever is there in the bracket. Now between these two exponents we will check. 3 power 5, 3 power 3. All are have, these two are having base 3. Between them, division operation is there. Yes? So, that is 3 to the power of 5 minus 3 whole power 5 I have already. Since in the bracket a power m by a power n formula we have used, what is that formula? A power m by a power n is equal to a to the power of m minus n. So a to the power of, that is 3 to the power of 5 minus 3. Now simplify first whatever is there in the bracket. That is 3 to the power of 5 minus 3 is 2. 3 square whole to the power of 5 into 3 power minus 6. This form we did not get till now, but I am telling inside the bracket exponential form. For exponent again we have the exponent. Then multiply these two exponents, that is in that one in the form of a power m whole power n. So what is its simplification? A to the power of m into n. That's all. So that is equal to, it is 3 square whole power 5 is in the form of a power m whole power n. Its simplification is a to the power of m into n. A power mn, that is nothing but m into n. 3 to the power of 2 into 5 into 3 power minus 6. 2 5s are 10. So 3 to the power of 10 into 3 power minus 6. Now observe, these two are in which form? A power m into a power n. So what is its simplification? A to the power of m plus n. Simplify by using that formula. 3 to the power of 10 plus half minus 6. 1 is plus, 1 is minus, subtraction. So 10 minus 6 is 4. 3 to the power of 4. 3 power of 4 value? 81. Okay? So in our next class, we will simplify some more examples on this laws of exponents.